again. This is Hardin County Commissioners Court. We're now here for our regular meeting and all members of the court are present. This meeting is called to order. Please rise for the invocation by Commissioner Young, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.
Lord, I just want to thank you for today and all of your many blessings. Be with us as we conduct the business of the county and keep us in your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Commissioner. Item 3, approved minutes of the October 26, 2021 regular meeting, November 4, 2021 special meeting, and November 8, 2021 special meeting as presented by the County Clerk, Linda Austin.
So moved.
Got a motion by Commissioner Roberts, second by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 4, consider approval of request to cancel all registered claims for October 26, 2021, and approval of cash statement as presented by the County Treasurer, Ms. McWilliams. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. I'm asking the court to release me of the liability of $1,187,190.35. On our cash report and general checking account, we have $9,327,394.01. In text pool, we have $321.09 for total and cash funds of $9,327,715.10.
Move to approve this presented.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes.
Thank you,
Ms. McWilliams. Item 5, authorization to pay county bills as presented by the County Auditor, Angela Gore. Good morning, Ms. Gore.
Good morning. The pre-approved expenditures for October the 27th through the 30th is $383,718.43. Pre-approved expenditures for November the 3rd through the 4th is $565,473.20. Expenditures for Commissioners Court today are $140,751.01. The total expenditures and transfers is $1,089,942.64. The gross payroll for November the 4th is $546,512.77 for a total transfers for that payroll is $670,166.
Move to pay the bill.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Kirkendall. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 6, take up for consideration and take possible action regarding one or more alternative plans for the redistricting of County Commissioners Court precincts. Take any and all appropriate actions regarding the redistricting of Hardin County political boundaries, including the acceptance of new boundaries for the Commissioners Court precincts and any modifications of any other boundaries. We've been here twice before on November the 4th and again yesterday regarding the redistricting of Hardin County political boundaries. The option one was presented to us by Eric McGee with Allison Bass and McGee. That is our consultant that we contracted with over a year ago regarding redistricting. After that time, as we discussed in the public hearing yesterday, Commissioner Cooper found an error with Wilson Road or Wilson Lane over off of Wheeler Road, and we asked Mr. McGee to correct that for us, and he did. When he did, he also created an option two to try to bring that maximum deviation number back down from, we were trying to get around 5%. Our original option one got us close to 5% at around 6%, but when Wilson Lane got corrected, that bumped us back up to 8.08%. So he provided an option two to us, and that was to move Quail Valley Estates into Commissioner Precinct 2, and that is our option two. All of that was presented to the public yesterday during the public hearing, and we're here now to vote on either option one or option two. And so at this time, I'll entertain a motion from the court on which option they would like to go with.
Move to approve option two.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall to accept option two as presented in the public hearing yesterday.
Second by Cooper.
Second by Cooper, that's right. Thank you, sir.
Yes,
any discussion? Is there any elected official present that would like to discuss option two and before we take a vote on this? this time we will vote on the motion made by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper to accept option two. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Let the record show that the vote was unanimous in favor of option two.
And Commissioner Cooper said January 1st?
Yes.
Are we sure about that?
No, sir.
The only reason I say that is because the filing period starts Saturday, and I think it takes effect today.
That's what I was thinking.
I think it has to take effect before
when I read it, it said January 1st, but I might have misread it. I am not 100%
positive. I think you read it right. I think you need to keep working on that area until January 1st.
We're working over there this week.
Thank you.
I should have confirmed that this morning, and I didn't.
Once you do, you'll let us know.
I'll do that.
Okay.
Because right. I think it has to take effect before November 13th. That's the first day to file to run for office. And so that's why I think it takes effect today. But I'll confirm that. I'll let everybody know.
Thanks.
Thank you, Jim.
Yes, sir. And I want to thank everybody for your patience and working on redistricting. I mean, as Commissioner Kirkendall said yesterday, this should have been done a long time ago. And or we at least should have known something a long time ago as to what the process was going to be and how long it would take. And we found out literally last Tuesday that it had to be done by this Friday before the first day to file to run for office, which is November the 13th. And so we did kind of rush it, and I hate that we did that, but I think what we've done is perfect, or as perfect as it can be. This does not settle the election precinct boundaries. That has to be done by December the 31st, and my goal is to have it done by December the, I think, 10th is our first regular meeting of December.
He's going to meet with us next week.
All right, so my goal is that we vote on that the first regular meeting in December and have that all put to bed on redistricting.
Is that a meeting in person?
He did not say. I don't know if it's going to be soon. Kind of think it's going to be soon.
Because I think it'd be good if me or Commissioner Cooper could be on there.
Yep.
To talk about
fine.
9 and 10.
Sounds good.
This was not easy, but I will say this. Ms. Cook and Ms. Yancey's work is cut out for them, as well as the 911 people. So, I mean, we're not the only ones that's involved in the process here. And y'all's work is just beginning, so
right.
We appreciate everything y'all do as well.
And we want to thank Carl and James with 911. I mean, they hurriedly put some maps together and sent them to us so we'd have them ready for yesterday. So thank y'all for doing that. And now that you know which option we went with, they're going to get to work on figuring the new road miles for each commissioner precinct.
And y'all issue supplemental paperwork to us?
The new 2022 book will be coming out
January.
And so just want to remind you guys, I sent some letters out for any pavement changes, mileage, anything like that, plus this redistricting stuff, of course. But all that will go in the 2022 book for part of the first court date in January.
Okay.
Sounds great.
Did we vote?
We did. It was unanimous. So we're going to move on now to item number 7, canvassing the results of the November 2nd, 2021 constitutional amendment election in accordance with section 67.007, Texas Election Code. Mrs. Austin,
okay.
If you would just kind of present this to us the same way you have in the past, I don't think it's necessary to read each and every item, just the winner.
Okay.
Or the amendments that passed or what have you. Whatever you need to do to keep it short.
Okay,
and short.
I'll just put Proposition 1 for 1,959 against 431. Is that good?
Yes, ma'am. Perfect. Thank you.
Proposition 2 for is 1,094 against is 1,285. Proposition 3, 2,050 against is 350. Proposition 4 for 1,467 against 868. Proposition 5 for is 1,467 against 856. Proposition 6 for is 2,192 against 204. Proposition 7 for 2,222 against 185. Proposition 8 for 2,230 against is 1,760. 176. Do you want me to give the results for the local, the...
Yes, ma'am, please.
Okay. Okay, the Lumberton Mud is 4, 493 against 359. Horn County Emergency District 5, 4 is 117 against is 134. Hardin County Emergency District 1, 4 is 113, against is 195. And I want to thank Alyssa for you.
Is she in here? Yep, there she is. She does a great job.
She does.
All of y'all do as a team. Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Are there any questions or comments regarding the canvas as it was presented by the county clerk? If not, I entertain a motion to accept.
Move to accept.
Second.
That motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 8, accept notice from Glenda Austin County Clerk concerning her retirement from office effective December 31st, 2021, and take possible action to appoint a successor to fill the unexpired term of office of the county clerk. Mrs. Austin has submitted a letter to us. And at this time, I'll ask her to say anything or make any remarks that she'd like to make regarding her announcement, official announcement of retirement. She did announce it during our last meeting, and I know that she's made her rounds to let everybody know over the past probably about 4 weeks. Mm-hmm. Let us know that she's leaving us, and I've asked her 100 times if she's sure, and she said
not
she's
positive.
More than sure.
I'm positive, yeah. I've enjoyed working for Hardin County, but I think after 36 years and 5 months, I'm ready to retire and do other things and enjoy life in a different way.
We certainly hate to see you go. I mean, with you and, of course, Commissioner Roberts announced recently that he's going to retire next year, and we have our human resources director and our maintenance supervisor, and I don't know if I'm forgetting anybody, but we're losing a whole lot of talent and experience with all of you leaving, and we're sad to see you go, but we're happy for you as well.
Thank you.
So,
I want to thank Hardin County, you know, the taxpayers. That's who I work for is the taxpayers, so I think I've satisfied them too through the years.
Well, you keep getting reelected, so I think you're right. For the most part, anyway. I think we've all know that we can't make everybody happy all the time, but we try. And so you have made a recommendation in your letter to
yes, I have.
Appoint a replacement, if you'd like to talk about that.
Okay. I would love to see Connie Beckman appointed. She's been a very good chief deputy. I don't know who she will appoint for chief deputy, but they have a lot to live up to as well.
So
because she has been a very good chief deputy. But we've all worked well together, so Connie's very dedicated. She knows all of the ins and outs of the office, so she'll be good.
All right, we have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall to accept the notice from Mrs. Austin. Does that also include the appointment of Ms. Beck?
Yes, sir.
All right, and that was seconded by Commissioner Young. Is that right?
Yes.
Any other discussion? Anything Ms. Beckman wants to say?
I just want to say thank you to the judge and the commissioners for appointing me, and most of all for Glenda for teaching me everything I know, and I miss her so much, and she's the most important one. I want to say thank you to Glenda. I appreciate everything you've done for me.
Thank you. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes and it's unanimous. So that's effective January 1st, but
yeah.
Right.
I just want to say too that you know, time was of the essence here to make an appointment. There's a lot of stuff that I'm sure I'm not even thinking about, but there's computer programs to change names on, there's envelopes, there's jury summons, there's the timestamp machine and lots of other things that y'all have to do. There's a bond that has to be put in place, quite a bit that has to be done, and as Mrs. Austin stated to all of us, normally that's done on an election day, and then they have 2 months to prepare, and so that is why she asked us to go ahead and make a decision today so that they could get started on getting a transition in place. So that's very important to do and make sure that everybody's ready starting January 1st. So good luck.
Thank you.
To both of you. Item 9, consider approval of request to pay Lumberton Culvert and Tank invoice number 3127 in the amount of $16,504 for culverts requested by Commissioner Rock.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Young. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Number 10, consider and possibly authorize the following fiscal year 22 budget amendment due to canceled fiscal year 21 purchase order requested by Sheriff Davis. This would be a $137.47 transfer from contingency general to training. And this is, can't remember what the purchase was for, but Adam couldn't be here by the end of last budget year, and the sheriff still needs it for training and is asking to move that into this budget year.
With considering how much it is, I'm not sure that we can do that, Sheriff. So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. I was reading the email. I still don't remember what it is, but it's very important, so we got it done. Item 11, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to execute Amendment 1 to interlocal cooperation contract for mental health liaison program with Spindle Top Center, requested by Sheriff Davis.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. This is for the mental health deputy.
Correct.
And there's no cost to the county for this.
Correct.
All right. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 12, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to execute interlocal cooperation contract for jail services with Spindle Top Center. Is there any change, Sheriff, from last year to this year on this agreement?
There is a slight change, Judge. It's in the amount of the fees. Of course, we're required by law to provide mental health services to inmates that come into the jail. And there's a sliding scale depending on what type of services. If it's something that could be handled by maybe just a licensed counselor as opposed to a psychiatrist, there's some different fees there. And those fees went up a very, very small amount. I think one of them was like from $40 to $55 an hour. So I reviewed that. My recommendation is to approve it, and I think it's been looked at by the county attorney as well. So.
And most of that that's done in the jail, y'all handle that by telemed, don't you?
There is a lot. It can escalate, though. If telemed doesn't serve the need of the inmate, then there could be an in-person visit. And again, depending on how many times or how far that goes or what they require, there's a continuity of care that we have to look at. So if a person's already receiving services through Spindle Top and they come into the jail, then we're required to make sure that those services continue. And so that's what a lot of this is.
Thank you very much.
Move to approve.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Young, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 13, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to execute interlocal cooperation contract with City of Beaumont, City of Port Arthur, Jefferson County, Jasper County, and Orange County for the Southeast Texas Auto Theft Task Force.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Commissioner Roberts, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Sheriff, Ms. Cook said she wanted to tell you something about these agenda items, but she'd wait till after the meeting. Right. Item 14, consider adoption of Resolution 31-21 in support of opioid settlement with Janssen. We have a letter in our packets from Simon Greenstone Panettiere regarding a settlement that's been reached with Janssen. This is only one of the defendants in our opioid, which I can never say correctly, lawsuit. Mr. Simon could not be here, but I believe he sent a representative.
Paul Henderson.
Yes, sir. Good morning, Mr. Henderson. So if any member of the court has any questions for Mr. Henderson regarding their recommendation to enter into the settlement agreement, the amount is $99,995. And again, that's only one defendant. There will be more coming. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. And I will
addition, there is a $14 million fund set aside in Region 2, which y'all are part of. There's about seven counties. You will also be able to petition for additional funds by way of grant. We'll be helping you with that. It's going to be set up. And also the good thing is we're funding December 31st, this settlement. There was an Attorney General settlement that was ongoing. It was a 9-year payout. We got them to pay. So the Attorney General stopped his negotiations. He joined us. So the settlement's been made by the AG, Johnson & Johnson, and our firm. But back to the $14 million, you will be able to petition for grants to receive money for opioid-type mitigation, I guess I would say. The $99,000 will be, it's past damages, so kind of whatever you want to do with it, it can be somehow tied in your minds reasonably to opioid, like law enforcement, training, health care, and these type of things. We hope this is a template for future settlements that we have. This one reason why we were able to take control of this settlement was we have a case set for trial in Dallas County, so that's driving the litigation right now. Also, good part of y'all is our attorney contract with y'all has been waived. Johnson & Johnson is paying our attorney fees. So that's another kind of important aspect for y'all to understand. And we highly recommend it, of course. I'd be glad to answer any questions if you have any.
When you said Region 2 a while ago, that's the DPS region?
No, it's a region. It's opioid region. It's set up as a special council, and it's a non-political a group of people that specialize in economic health and statistical health matters. And it is, I'll give you the names of your Region 2.
I think it's nine counties, starting with Brazoria.
Angelina, Brazoria, Galveston, Hardin, Jefferson, Liberty, Nacogdoches, Newton, Orange, Polk, Sabine, San Augustine, San Jacinto, Shelby, and Tyler. So it's kind of a deep southeast Texas corridor. We anticipate you will also be able to maybe partner with grants with other counties in this region, perhaps a neighboring county or something that can be done also. I think there's going to be a lot of latitude. We're going to help you over that when it's up and running. Funding's to be December 31st, as you know, as usual. That means, and the funding is important because Johnson & Johnson did a talc settlement with Nationwide a few months back. And the day after, you know, within 6 months or 8 months, they filed for bankruptcy, so all those settlements went away. So we insisted on immediate settlement, immediate funding. The money will go to the comptroller. Your check won't come from us, it'll come from the comptroller. And then they'll be setting up next year also the $14 million fund to be drawn from. All that money's gonna be paid. That 14 is not just sitting there for nothing. It's gonna all be paid out. And they're gonna set up a form of how we do the grants. And we'll keep you apprised. Of course, I would add Jeff is Simon is liaison and head counsel of almost every opioid piece of litigation in the entire United States. So we have a great hand in him. He's extremely knowledgeable, and I think he'll be very helpful to us and passing down to us to help everybody get this moving for grandma.
Well, I'd just like to say thank you for working on behalf of those people who've suffered loss at the hands of opioids. 20 years of ministry, I've done a lot of funerals of accidental overdoses. And I've sat across from spouses and children who have a loved one who's addicted to opioids. I hate them.
Yeah.
So it would make me happy if you could bankrupt them.
We do too, and I would just add.
Not before they pay us, though.
Yeah.
Yes. I agree.
It is a shame that some of the people are not serving time in prison for what they did to promote this. It was all a manufactured promotion to, as you know, to elevate the use to and to cause all this addiction and all this death. And
yes, sir.
Exactly right, sir.
Thank you very much.
I move to accept.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Roberts to accept the resolution, seconded by Commissioner Young. Only question I have is how many other defendants are there besides?
There's about 12, but we also, we have bankruptcy claims filed for Purdue, for instance. Anybody goes bankrupt, we file a claim. And we also have, if there's a nationwide settlement for someone else, that there will be participation as well. And I do also have that authorization also is to sign a release form so I can get this in. And I will present this if you like.
You want to sign it, Ben?
I don't know. Gonna get us some money, I'll sign it.
Right.
We appreciate you being here today.
Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. We'll get the resolution to you as well.
Thank you. I'm gonna scan those to me or.
Sure.
Perfect. And then I'll have them and I'll forward them on up to Dallas.
Sounds perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you for being
here.
Thank you
for being here. It is a pleasure representing you and we'll continue to.
Sounds good. Thank you very much. Item 15, consider adoption of Resolution 32-21 to cast votes in the election of the Board of Directors of Hardin County Appraisal District. We have something a little different this year than we have in the past. Normally, we take the recommendation or the nomination from each independent school district. There are 5 independent school districts, and I believe there are 5 members that serve on the board of the Hardin County Appraisal District, but this year we have 6 names to choose from. And I believe that is because the City of Silsbee has also put forth a nominee. So there are 2 versions of Resolution 32-21. And I would just ask, honestly, I would probably defer to the 2 commissioners that represent Silsbee to discuss how they'd like to proceed regarding this resolution.
Judge, I have spoke with Commissioner Kirkendall on this. Like you said, this is something new. I'm not really sure. I have not been contacted, nor have I had any communication at all with anybody from the City of Silsbee. I'd like some time to do that, so I would make a motion to table this until I can speak to someone from the City of Silsbee to see what this is. As far as I know, it's never been done in the past, except ISB. So,
second. I have a motion by Commissioner Cooper to table item number 15, seconded by Commissioner Kirkendall. And if you'll just let us know when to put it back on the agenda, I think we have to do it by December the 15th.
Thank you.
All in favor to table?
Aye.
Any opposed? Item 15 is tabled. Item 16, consider and possibly authorize request for approval to apply for a $25,000 nacho grant with support from Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, Division of Healthcare Quality Promotion, for a new funding opportunity to advance capacity to prevent and control healthcare-associated infections and engage in antimicrobial-resistant related initiatives. Most importantly, she says there's no local match required, and this is requested by the Health Director, Sharon Whitley.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Roberts, second by Commissioner Young. So in terms I can understand, what's this exactly for? What are y'all going to do? Didn't we do this last year?
Yes and no. We didn't have a grant to do this. This is, we're going to be working closely with the nursing home.
Okay.
With infectious disease.
Yes, ma'am.
And we are currently doing that right now with the state.
All right. Thank you. And NACHO stands for something. NACCHO?
National Association of City and County Health Officials.
Perfect. Just making me hungry, right?
Yes.
Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. And this is an application y'all handle directly in-house?
Yes.
Okay.
I'll wait with you.
That's not her last name anymore. Item 17, consider approval of request by City of Sour Lake for Hardin County to abandon a portion of a 50-foot undeveloped road called Wild Street that runs east and west from lots 10 through 19, block 4. A 16-foot alleyway that runs north and south between lots 1 through 10, 11, and 28, block 4. and a 16-foot alleyway that runs east and west between lots 11 through 19 and lots 20 through 28 in block 4, located in the Jackson second addition to the town of Sour Lake. This is a request made by Mr. Parker, the floodplain administrator. We held a public hearing on this at 9:45 this morning. There were no comments from the public for or against this. Commissioner Young is making the motion to approve, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. Mayor and Zeke, we appreciate y'all being here today.
Appreciate
thank you very much.
Thank you.
And didn't mean to keep you this long, but thank you for staying.
I just have to go back to work.
Yes, sir. The boss is right next to you. I guess you do have to.
Yeah, I have to since he's here.
Yeah, I watched him work.
Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank y'all. And good luck on your water and sewer project.
Thank you.
Item 18, record in the minutes of the court the 2021 Officer Appreciation Awards presented by Hardin County Crime Victims Assistance Center on October 26th. 2021. Ms. Jacks, you want to come on forward? I'll read these off and then you can talk about them or say whatever you'd like to say. Tell you what, why don't you just read them off? The award recipients are as follows. Go ahead, Ms. Jacks.
I'm Sergeant Chad Wilson from Lumberton Police Department, received the Servant's Heart Award. Chief Sean Blackwell of Silsbee Police Department, received the Excellence in Support of Prosecution for Felony Court Award. Game Warden Mark Nelson with Texas Parks and Wildlife received the Excellence in Support of Prosecution Misdemeanor for County Court. And Sheriff Mark Davis received the Leadership Award. And the Hardin County Crime Victims Officer of the Year was Sergeant Investigator Kendra Simmons.
Well, Sergeant Wilson's here and Sheriff Davis is here. I just want to say, Sergeant Wilson's here virtually. I just want to say, and I'm sure that his name's here. I guess he's here. I'm sure he is. I just want to say thank you for taking the time to put that banquet together. I think it was, from what I hear, was very well done. So thank you and your staff for doing that. And congratulations to all the award recipients. I think they're all worthy, and I'm sure the other members of the court would like to say something.
Go ahead. Congratulations to all.
Yes, and it was a very good banquet. I appreciate it. Food was excellent, so be sure to pass that along. It was really good.
Yes, Dave Bolton did the cooking. He did a very good job.
Yes.
All right, awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Item 19, considering possibly authorize the purchasing agent to solicit proposals from firms to conduct a compensation study of all elected, appointed, and all Hardin County personnel. A request made by Commissioner Cooper.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion?
Yes.
Commissioner Cooper.
Judge, this is a request that I made, being that we have a committee put together by you for the salary adjustments for the county. I spoke with Sheriff Davis and other members of the committee. This is probably not something that we will actually go into an agreement with, but one thing that we would like to do, I was made aware of the fact that two surrounding counties had recently had a salary adjustment done by an outside company, and we would like to find out what the results of that was, as well as what the cost and where this company is out of. So that's why I asked to put this on the agenda.
Sounds good. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 20, consider and possibly authorize request to purchase 2021 K621G Z-Bar T4 wheel loader, serial number NMF253360, in the amount of $166,248.62, utilizing a cooperative purchasing agreement. This purchase will be financed for a term not to exceed 5 years. Requested by Commissioner Kirkendall.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Commissioner Cooper, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. Any discussion?
Yes, sir. When we finance this, the payments are going to be in the arrears. And so what I would ask, with all the redistricting going on, if we could wait to put it into the next budget that we'll have approved for October, and not really have to move money around this year, because it will be in the arrears.
So that'll come to court later, the financing?
Yes.
Because there'll have to be a resolution and all of that, is that right?
Yes, sir. And I was also going to add that
So once you have all the financing ready and bring it back to court, just make sure that Commissioner Kirkendall's request is honored, that the first payment doesn't start until October of 2022.
Yes, I think that's what Bancor has quoted this. Yeah.
Okay. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 21, consider approval of request to accept grant funds from Walmart Community Grants Foundation in the amount of $4,000 for the annual Hardin County Courthouse Christmas tree lighting to be held Tuesday, December 7th, 2021. A request by Regina Bolton.
So moved. Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Roberts. And I checked with the auditor and there was no budget amendment needed. There's already a line item to put those funds into. Correct? Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Congratulations, Regina, on getting those grants.
Congratulations, everyone.
Item 22, consider approval of request to submit multiple grant applications associated with the health inspector through the FDA/NEHA retail standards program for 2022. No match is required for any of these grants. A request made by the health inspector, Regina Bolton.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Young, is that right? Seconded by Commissioner Roberts?
Something like that.
It's all right.
Kind of tied, yeah.
Well, there's a bunch of talking, I didn't catch it all, but I think I'm right. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 23, recognize Commissioner Kirkendall for his article in the recent edition of County Progress. I don't know if y'all ever read the County Progress magazine. It's a magazine that's put out by TAC. But in the one of the most recent editions that we had, there was a glimpse in the life of a Texas County Commissioner, and Commissioner Kirkendall was featured in that. So to my knowledge, I don't know that we've ever had, since I've been here, a County Commissioner that was recognized in County Magazine or County Progress. Am I missing anybody? So congratulations, Commissioner. You represented Hardin County very well. Is there anything you want to talk about regarding the article that was in the magazine?
Well, when she called me, I said, no. And she's like, sounds like you don't want to do it. I said, well, if you're asking me, I'm saying no. But if you want me to, I'll say yes. She said, well, I want you to. So I said, okay. So it was a privilege and an honor. And my wife enjoyed it. So I don't know if anybody else will, but she did.
Well, if y'all haven't seen it, I'll send it out to everybody after court today. And it's a very nice article regarding a glimpse in the life of Commissioner Kirkendall. So congratulations on that, and we appreciate you representing Hardin County in that article.
Thank you, Judge.
Yes, sir.
He'll be signing paperwork for anybody who wants to get it.
That's right.
Yeah,
don't do autographs.
Yeah. Already got mine.
It could lead to an investigation.
All right, item 24, consider and possibly authorize the county judge to execute two agreements with the Southeast Texas Flood Control District for flood sensors. The agreements are a memorialization of transfer of custody of flood sensors and an agreement to abide by CRADA and a data plan agreement. This is requested by the floodplain administrator, Alex Parker. I've participated with Mr. Parker and Captain Tupper in the first couple of meetings they had with Lamar regarding these flood sensors, and then I haven't participated in many of them since then. But I think we're getting four. We may get some more later. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. We're going to pick up four. We're going to try to get those done today.
And these are going to go where, these flood sensors?
I talked to Tupper. We were thinking like Boggy Creek, the north part up on Highway 69 of Village Creek. They are covered in some areas, but mainly the lower part and the creek that feed into Pine Island Bayou.
And the flood sensors came to us through a grant. I guess they came to Lamar through a grant, and they're being shared with the region.
Yes, sir.
And there may be some more later. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
And so these are the first four locations. If anybody has any ideas for any other locations later, if you'll just let Mr. Parker know, he'll make sure and put those on the list. And these will all be tied into a network where we can go online and look them up to see what the elevations are and things like that. It's primarily there to warn you when a flood's coming and to be able to tell what the level is of these waterways. Is that correct? All right. And Mr. Minnick has reviewed both agreements and says they are good to go if the court agrees.
Move to approve.
Second.
Have a motion by Commissioner Kirkendall, seconded by Commissioner Cooper. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes. Item 29, discussion only of any item not on the agenda without taking any action. I just want to remind everybody that tomorrow is our Hardin County Thanksgiving Feast that is sponsored by Judge Brewer, and that'll be over at the County Annex building, and does that start at 11? Is that right? All right, so 11 o'clock tomorrow. Yes, sir, go ahead.
I just wanted to, on the 2022 Hardin County Atlas book, if you commissioners could get me your road types and changes and stuff like that by November 18th or 19th, so we can start processing that in December.
All right, sounds good. I think Ms. Bolton, yes, sir.
And also, do y'all have any subdivision roads that have been through the warranty period that are now county roads?
After the warranty period?
Yeah, because sometimes the warranty periods expire and it becomes a county road and we still have it listed as a private.
I don't think we've done any recently, have we?
I don't think so, yeah.
There was a period of time we did several right in the road. I don't think we've done any in the past year. Okay. Y'all will pay attention to that and see if there's any. Ms. Bolton had something she wanted to say. Go ahead.
Yes, I just wanted to kind of mention, Deborah, we're doing something a little different for our tree lighting this year, which is on a Tuesday, December the 7th. And we're going to have booths, and we're trying to get department heads, city organizers, law enforcement agencies, all the different people, that anybody that wants to have a booth. And we're setting up, because for the kids, you can do a game booth, you can do an educational booth, whatever you might like to do to set up for the kids. You got a little 10 by 10 area, and we're going to set them up all around where the top of that big tree is and then down the way a little bit. But the goal is we're getting a bunch of big, because you can't give every kid that comes a present, but we're going to buy a bunch of big gifts, and each kid that participates in a game will get a raffle ticket. They'll take that ticket with their name and number and drop it in whatever prize they want to win. So the more tickets they get, the more chances they get to put their names and prizes, then we're going to draw and do that. But we were trying to bring, we want everybody in the county, this is a countywide thing, this isn't the city, this is, you know, this is the countywide deal. So we want representatives from Sour Lake, from every area, Silsby, Lumberton, everybody to be there and be a part of it. So y'all can give away anything that you like, trinkets, you know, whatever, candy, and I'll supply the tickets. I'm going to take care of the tickets that y'all are going to give to the kids, so you don't have to worry about that. And there is going to be a contest for the best decorated booths. Now, trophies speak miles here, okay? I know everybody will fight for a trophy. Sheriff's already in. He left, but he's in already. So, anyway, anybody would like to, please get with me, get with Glenda. You know, we'd love to have y'all on board and do this. It's going to be a lot of fun. And, again, the more we want to bring the community out and just barrel those. And it's all for the kids. We've got free hot dogs, free links, free coffee, free hot chocolate, free cookies, face paint, Santa Claus, and we got all kind of things, and it's geared towards the kids. And I think, you know, we need to do it last year, so it's going to be big. We're really pushing it, and we're expecting it to be a really big success. So we'd love to have everybody that can be on board.
Can we go through the food line twice?
Okay, here's the plan. You can, but you only get one ticket.
That's right. Thank you, Regina.
You're welcome.
Anybody else, any other official have anything they want to announce? Member of the court?
The 18th, if I think I remember correctly, the regional flood committee plan, whatever they have, the regional, is having a meeting in Silsby at the community center at 9.
At 9 a.m.? All right, great. Anything else? And we'll move on to the very last item, the most important one. Had a motion by Commissioner Young to adjourn, seconded by Commissioner Roberts.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
We are adjourned. I hope everybody has a great week. Thank you all for being here.